second round of bosses to beat here. Terror Man, Plague Man, Flare Man, and Power Man. Sound pretty intimidating, if you kind of think about it. We don't get any weapons or anything from these guys, so order doesn't really matter. I'm gonna start with Power Man. Just because. I kind of made reference to Doc Robot last time, but that's probably not exactly a fair comparison, because these are unique stages. These are not, these are not based off of any the previous stages that we're at, so it's, a lot of significant content. Which is different from Doc Robots, because those ones were basically, variants of the stages we already did. Exactly, do that the best way. Alright, oh, hey, guess what? We have viruses. Just like when Virus Man stage, these ones will, reverse your controls, so watch out. Whoa. And of course, shield attackers, because conveyor belts weren't annoying enough for it. There's one place I do not want to get reverse controls, it is on air. That's going to be a bit too much of a problem. Special weapon help there. I think I'll be able to start talking again, because I won't be horrifically scared about everything that's going on. That's what I was hoping. Alright. Onward! Upward. Apparently very upward. What do you got for me? Got more power for you. And more power for you. Like, I get you like being powered up. Sorry, Rush. I got a false signal over there. You guys! You're kind of, hardy. I guess I shouldn't bother trying to destroy you. Just rush past. Fortunately, Mega Man climbs a little bit faster in this game than he does in the original Mega Man. So, so I don't have to have trouble getting past all the obstacles. Whoa! Oh! It's Nitro Man! Sorry, Nitro Man! I, You know, it just kind of popped out from right behind me. That's kind of frightening, if you ask me. Yes, the rescued members of the rock force do help out. I probably shouldn't waste my time trying to destroy all of you. But maybe one or two of you here and there. So that you don't destroy my face, and various other parts of my body. I might be able to block those with the pulse stopper, but I think I'll just be careful instead. Whenever you see a hazard that messes with your movement, you know that eventually it's going to be paired with spikes. Fortunately, this one isn't very bad. I say as I get myself walloped by that. Now, see, I knew that was coming, but I didn't plan for it. Just pressing forward, pretty much all you need to do. I knew you were gonna come over here. It's like, I'm getting better at predicting. This feels like a good place for an ambush there to be. Fortunately, I'm not seeing these, so. That have traveling patterns. Kind of used to these because they are like sparkies. Doesn't mean I'll do perfectly on them because positioning and all that, but it's not as foreign an enemy as it might seem. Well, we're almost at Power Man here. Get myself killed on spikes. I cannot get myself killed on spikes. These guys have weaknesses, but I don't remember what they are, so I'm just gonna have to play around with it. Oh yeah, this guy, virus has just disappeared. Good. The way to actually attack him is a good old friend ricochet. I mean, it's a preferred way to attack him, but you can only attack him a limited times there. Whereas if you use Pulse Stopper, you can get him whenever you want. That's why I use Pulse Stopper. And, well, we don't get a weapon from him, so that's about all from here. But, we get a nice nifty little icon that shows that we defeated him. Anyway, that's all from me for now. Until next time, this is Doc. I'll see you later.